We're going to find the area of this shaded region again, and unlike all of the previous problems on this playlist, you'll notice that there isn't a clear upper and lower function throughout this region. The red function represents the upper and lower portion through here, and then sort of in this section, the blue function is the upper function, and the red function is the lower function, and then that changes again over here. It's kind of messy if we try to integrate this the way that we have in the past. Instead, you'll notice that there is a very clear function on the right side of this area, and a very clear function on the left side of this area. Therefore, what we're going to do is we're going to take the right function minus the left function as sort of this sideways height of this region, and we are going to integrate this with respect to y. What that's going to look like in this case is, again, an integral of the rightmost function, that's 2y minus y squared, minus the leftmost function, which is y squared minus 4y, and we're going to integrate that with respect to y, and these limits on this integral then should be the upper and lower y values in the region. So you'll notice that the smallest y value in the region is right here, and it's 0. The largest y value in the region is right here, and it is 3. So simplifying this, integrating, and plugging in our limits is going to give us the result that we're looking for. If we combine like terms, we get a negative 2y squared and a plus 6y, it looks like to me, which gives us negative 2/3 y cubed plus 6y squared over 2, which is 3y squared. We're going to evaluate that from 0 to 3. If we plug in our upper limit of 3, we get this here. And if we plug in our lower limit of 0, you'll notice that everything in this function just turns out to be 0. That simplifies things a little bit for us. We get negative 2/3 times 27, which is negative 18 if we cancel the 3 in the denominator with one of the 3s in the numerator. And this piece gives us a plus 27. It looks to me like the final answer is going to be 9. And that is it. So what we learned in that problem is that if we have a region that we want to find the area of, that instead of having a clear upper and lower function, has a clear right and left function, we can integrate that then with respect to y using the rightmost function minus the leftmost function as the integrand. Of course, if we're integrating with respect to y, the functions that we use should be in terms of y. But fortunately, in this problem, and conveniently, they gave us these two functions in terms of y. So, okay, we are finished with that problem. I hope it helps.